At last, my love has come along.
The pledge that they have made today will last forever. Now, a pledge is a word that is really strong. It's much stronger than commitment. It's much stronger than vow. It's much stronger than promise. Because it comes from the heart. And it will be there forever.
The skies above are blue. My heart was wrapped up in clover. The night I looked at you, I found a dream that I could speak to, a dream that I can call my own. I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that I have never known. Oh yeah, yeah. You smile.
Thank you. friends and family of Jennifer and Steve, welcome. Thank you for being here on this most important and joyous occasion. We share with them their delight in finding love with each other. Tonight we celebrate this love as Jennifer and Steve unite in marriage. Before we begin, let's please take a moment to remember family and friends who cannot be here to celebrate this evening. Jennifer, Steve, your marriage begins with the promises and commitments you make to each other this evening. Do you, Steve, promise to love Jennifer, to respect her, and to share your life and your dreams with her?
I do.
Do you promise to build with her a home that is a place of love, happiness, passion, and growth?
I do.
Do you promise to be a loving husband to her in all of her successes and failures, all of her happiness and sadness, and to always give her your unwavering support?
I do.
Do you, Jennifer, promise to love Steve, to respect him, and to share your life and your dreams with him?
I do.
Do you promise to build with him a home that is a place of love, happiness, passion, and growth?
I do.
Do you promise to be a loving wife to him in all of his successes and failures, all of his happiness and sadness, and to always give him your unwavering support?
I do.
I invite Linda Parr, the mother of the bride, and Marianne Hampton, the mother of the groom, to please come forward to light their candles. These candles offer us a symbol of the coming together of two families in allegiance to and support for this couple.
This marriage, most like an arch, an entrance which upholds, ensures the stone, crush up the air like lace. Mass-made idea, an idea held in place, a lock in time, inside half heaven unfolds. Most like an arch, two weaknesses that lean into a strength, two fallings become firm, two joined abeyances become a term. Naming the fact that teaches fact to me. Not quite that, not much less. World as it is, what strong and separate falters. All I do at piling stone on stone apart from you is roofless around nothing. Till we kiss, I'm no more than upright and unset. It is by falling in and in we make all the bearing point for one another's sake and faultless failing, raised by our own weight.
I invite John Schuster to share a second reading.
I can't promise you. I can't promise you that dark clouds will never hover over our lives or that the future will bring us many rainbows. I can't promise you that tomorrow will be perfect or that our lives will be easy. I can promise you my everlasting devotion, my loyalty, my respect, and my unconditional love for my loved one. I can promise you that I'll always be there for you to listen and to hold your hand and to always do the best to make you happy and make you feel loved. I can promise you that I'll see you through any crisis and hope that you will, and hope with you, dream with you, build with you, and always cheer you on and encourage you. I can promise that I will share my dreams, my world, and my every aspect of my life with you. I will willingly be your protector, your advisor, your counselor, your friend, your family, and your everything, and believe that's truly what love is truly all about.
There is a delightful sort of irony in the location of Jennifer and Steve's first encounter. A dark, dank, dingy lagering cellar under the city of Cincinnati. When we imagine the spaces where the sparks of attraction might flicker into the warmth of true love, an abandoned beer tunnel is not high on the list. But there it is. Jennifer was doing some volunteer work when she saw Steve. She thought he was cute, and by way of getting to know him, offered to shine a light on the work he was doing to clear the tunnel. Now, we know Steve is passionate about the brewery district, but on that occasion, he was not so focused on his work that he didn't notice Jennifer. They went on a date at a presumably less gritty location, and here we are. What I love about this story is the precision with which it reveals certain characteristics, both about Jennifer and Steve, and the relationship they have together. I want to highlight a few of these characteristics, and I'll do so with the help of input from Jennifer and Steve's friends and family, whom I have asked for input, so that we could offer a collective reflection on their love. Jennifer is a kind, generous soul, exactly the sort of woman who would volunteer to clean out a lagering tunnel. A friend remarked, "Jennifer is as nice as anyone I have ever met. She is good to people. She has a genuine concern for helping others." A member of Jennifer's family said, "She has an innate kindness and understanding that puts people at ease and makes them feel like they've known her forever." At one of Jennifer's showers, the topic of conversation turned to her smile, which, as we all know, is one of those 1,000-watt grins that absolutely lights up the room. In the words of one friend, she perpetually radiates awesomeness. And she does. I don't know that I've ever left Jennifer's presence without a bit of that shine. She is always positive and upbeat. But she's also tough and determined. This is a woman who finished law school while holding a demanding full-time job. Not a plan for the weak of heart. And yet she handled it, to quote her aunt, with spunk and grace and the determination to keep going. And Steve? Steve is passionate, driven, serious, jovial and fun, but serious. Let's face it, one does not take on the redevelopment of a good portion of a major metropolis without a strong work ethic and a laser focus. But Steve is not just focused on work. He's equally passionate about family, friends, football, architecture. And Steve does not half-step anything, even and especially when creating happiness for friends and family. This is a man who, back in the day, would arrive very early, really very early, to Longworth Hall to get 2 parking spaces for the Bengals-Browns tailgate games. 1 space for his truck, and 1 space for the trailer, to which he'd latched 2 grills. Those were good times. Then he would water and feed all of us before handing out tickets, herding his flock to the stadium, and cheering on the Browns to victory. Or not. Steve is also deeply loyal to the people he loves. Once a friend, he is a friend for life. He is patient, understanding, and empathetic. Steve and Jennifer met just as she was accepted to law school. Like that lagering tunnel, the crushing workload of law school is not an ideal scenario for new love. But Steve was supportive through it all. He gave Jennifer the time and space she needed to accomplish her goals, and he waited to ask for her hand for 4 years until graduation. And when Jennifer's schedule was so restrictive that she could not go to the annual Hampton Beach reunions, Steve stayed home as well. One of Jennifer's family members summed it up. Steve is a calm and steady force in Jennifer's life, and he shares her characteristic thoughtfulness and kindness. And so really, it's no surprise that Jennifer volunteered to shine a light while Steve set about making a dirty lagering cellar part of an amazing brewery tour. Once word got out that Jennifer and Steve were a pair, there was, and I don't think I'm alone here, a strong sense that they were going to be together forever. There was, I understand, a pool running for the engagement, and a particular young lady was very willing to serve as a flower girl very early on. Anyone who has spent any time in their presence can see what Jennifer and Steve have together. Positivity, joy, happiness, passion, drive, kindness, generosity. Exactly what they will need to have a long and loving marriage. To close, I'd like to offer just a few thoughts from the family and friends. I have never seen Steve as happy as he is now with Jen in his life. His smile when they are together, even when he mentions her name, has never been brighter. From the start, they were extremely supportive of each other and took a genuine interest in each other's interests. They both work hard to attain their goals, and they are both very reliable with their promises. One thing that stood out for us from the very beginning was Jen's ability to soften Steve, if you will. At times when Steve might be focused on the task at hand, Jen would draw him out, relentlessly poke at him, refusing his short answers until Steve was talking and laughing. The two of them support each other's dreams, tease each other, plan together. I could not be happier for them. They deserve every bit of happiness that comes their way. Jennifer and Steve, it's time to pledge your love to each other with your vows.
I, Steve, take you, Jennifer.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to take you as no other than yourself.
I promise to take you as no other than yourself.
And to grow with you in love and spirit.
And to grow with you in love and spirit.
I promise to love, honor, and trust you.
I promise to love, honor, and trust you.
I promise to support you in plenty and in want.
I promise to support you in plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In failure and in triumph.
In failure and in triumph.
I promise to be true and loyal to you.
I promise to be true and loyal to you.
And to cherish you so long as we both shall live.
And to cherish you so as long as we both shall live.
Nicely done. Ready? I, Jennifer, take you, Steve.
I, Jennifer, take you, Steve.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to take you as no other than yourself.
I promise to take you as no other than yourself.
And to grow with you in mind and spirit.
And to grow with you in mind and spirit. I promise to love, honor, and trust you.
I promise to support you in plenty and in want.
I promise to support you in plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In failure and in triumph.
In failure and in triumph.
I promise to be true and loyal to you.
I promise to be true and loyal to you.
And to cherish you so long as we both shall live.
And to cherish you so long as we both shall live.
At their engagement, Steve offered Jennifer a very special ring. The ring his grandmother wore as a symbol of the love she shared with her husband for 65 years. That ring and the nearly 100 years of marriage between Steve's parents and Jennifer's parents give Steve and Jennifer representations and reminders of lasting love. Steve, as you place the ring. Jennifer, I give you this ring.
Jennifer, I give you this ring.
As a pledge of my love.
As a pledge of my love.
And as the symbol of our unity.
And as the symbol of our unity.
We almost got it. There we go.
Ready? Ready. Steve, I give you this ring.
Steve, I give you this ring.
As the pledge of my love.
As a pledge of my love.
And as the symbol of our unity.
And as the symbol of our unity.
Time for the candle. We're almost
okay.
A marriage brings together two individuals with separate lives to perform the lifelong pledge of uniting as one. The lighting of a unity candle is a symbol of two people becoming one in marriage. These candles before us symbolize the union of your marriage. The two outer candles represent the two of you as individuals. The center candle, which you will kindle together, represents the unity that will continue to develop as you are married. The external candles will remain lit to show, even in your unity, that you may remain as individuals. By the power given to me by you, the state of Ohio, and the click of a mouse, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Steve, you may kiss your bride. Introducing for the first time as a married couple, Jennifer Parr and Steve Hampton. Woo!
Everybody, and what a beautiful evening this is. Look at that sunset for you who haven't seen it yet. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Tom Parr, F-O-B. That's an F as in Father of the Bride. And I am just absolutely thrilled to be able to say that. You've all just witnessed the wedding, and the word wedding is kind of a cool word, and it comes from the German word wed, which translated means pledge. I've known Steve and Jennifer as a couple, I've known her for a long time, for 4+ years, and in that time, the pledge that they have made today will last forever. Now, a pledge is a word that is really strong. It's much stronger than commitment
It's much stronger than vow. It's much stronger than promise. Because it comes from the heart. And it will be there forever. And I'm supposed to talk for 10 minutes. You know what? I'm done. And I would like to introduce the newly married, wedded, pledged couple in their very first dance. Thank y'all.
There are millions of places I could be, but I'm here by your side.
Cousins, but over the years, closer here? Okay. We were born cousins, but over the years we've become dear friends. And Jennifer stood with me on my wedding day, and I'm so honored to stand with Jennifer and Steve today, so I thank you both for that. I recently wrote to Jen and Steve that I did not have the words to express how happy I were for both of them. And so I'm going to borrow some words tonight, and my simple wish for you, in the words of Leo Tolstoy, are seize the moments of happiness, love, and be loved. So, if we can raise our glass to Jen and Steve. May Jen's beautiful smile forever be accompanied by Steve's rich laughter. May you feel all the warm wishes and love in this room for you, and may you forever have all the love and joy that you both deserve. Love you guys.
Show the world the warmth of your smile, but more than anything. My wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want it to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're back,
Thank you, everybody. My name is Jay. I'm Steve's younger brother. I'm not quite as prepared as my brother is at putting on events, so I have some written down notes here that I'm going to go by. For starters, though, thank everybody for coming. It's very rare in our lives that we get together with all of our loved ones like this to celebrate such a great occasion. So for all of us here, and for Steve and Jen especially, thank you. This is great for all of us to be able to get together and celebrate. Being the younger brother of Steve, I grew up being picked on a lot. So this is actually kind of fortunate. I've had 38 years of material that I've got to gather. So I hope everybody has a comfortable seat as I rattle through some of Steve's memories. Just kidding. They say every family has their characters. And in our family, Steve was definitely the overachiever. Everything he did, he was always disciplined. He was dedicated. He was focused. He wanted to be an Eagle Scout. He became an Eagle Scout. He used to build skyscrapers with Lincoln logs when we were little, putting my little Lego models and to shame, and he became an architect. After he graduated college, he wanted to buy buildings and renovate them in Over the Rhine, which he's still working on that. He bought the buildings, but we're working on the renovation. Anyways, the point is Steve has always been very driven in everything he's done, which has been great. He's achieved a lot in his life, and it's been great. The only downside to that is that as Steve got older, I think I probably with the family we would agree he lost a little bit of that lovable Steve, the guy looking to have a good time and everything, until 2010 when he met Jen, and she brought a lot of that back. Steve stopped going on vacations with us, stopped maybe visiting his parents as often as he should have, but Jen brought that all back out of him. And I used to wonder what her magic potion was, but I don't think it's really a magic potion. I think the fact is they both found their equal. Steve and Jen are no more useless information about things that they can rattle off back to one another. They can have great debates, especially now that Jen's a lawyer. She wins a lot more, probably, but it doesn't stop them from debating. So it's really been great as she's become part of our family to bring the real Steve out that we all know is there. So maybe lastly, three quick toasts here. The first one, Jennifer, thank you for making Steve a better man. It's not that funny. I guess it's kind of funny. Maybe it is. He was a pretty good guy, but now he's even better. Steve, thank you for being a big brother and being the best big brother a guy could ask for, and one that I'm proud to have as mine. And lastly, to both of you, thank you for showing us that it's never too late or too early to find true love. And cheers.
Whoa, come on, baby, just take time. And all through my heart, every time I say a little prayer for you. Forever, forever, you'll stay in my heart, and I will love you forever and ever. We never will part. Oh, how I'll love you together, together. That's how it must be to live without you. Would only mean heartbreak for me. You love me too.